Today I'm taking up four questions we are frequently asked about overhead cranes. Welcome to Rigging Cues. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today I'm answering your questions about overhead cranes. Remember, you're the lift director here. If you have a question you want answered, drop it in the comments below. First question, what can I expect to pay for when purchasing an overhead crane besides the crane itself? There is a fair amount of hidden costs for overhead cranes, both when initially purchasing an overhead crane and throughout its lifespan. If you're going to be doing any sort of bracing or support off your building, you're going to need to test that your building can support the load of your crane. Test the concrete. You need to test that your foundation can support your crane's load. If these tests turn up anything that would cause a problem, then you're going to need to pay for some extra engineering to get these issues resolved. Throughout the lifespan of your crane, you're going to need to get it inspected. According to ASME B32 Overhead and Gantry Cranes, there are five types of inspections required for overhead cranes. Initial, periodic, frequent, cranes not in regular use, and functional. OSHA requires periodic inspections to be documented and performed by a qualified person, with the frequency depending on service, environmental, and application factors. Should I give my building's blueprints to my overhead crane manufacturer? Ideally, yes. It makes it much easier to have a copy of the original design drawings. The more information they have, the faster and smoother the process. Now, if you don't have these drawings, most companies should be able to come measure and collect all the information they need to get you an accurate quote and let you know if you will need any extra engineering to get your crane up and running. I'm building a new facility. Should I design the crane or the building first? Okay, interesting. So we've got a chicken or the egg situation here. If you're constructing a new building, it actually is much easier to design the building around the crane itself rather than try to design a crane to fit inside a building. When you design the building around the crane's application, you know that the crane will easily be able to perform that application without any compromises. Once the building is up or the designs are finalized, you're limited to that space and therefore limiting what your overhead crane can do. Contact your crane manufacturer in the planning stages of your build. Oh, and another bonus, you can actually use your overhead crane in the setup of your shop before production even begins. Do you need to load test an overhead crane as part of a periodic inspection? No. OSHA standard 1910-179 requires load tests for new and altered cranes. So unless the crane has been modified, upgraded, re-rated, etc., you do not need to perform a load test as part of a periodic inspection. If you're looking for more information on any of these topics, check out the links in the description. We also have a ton of information on anything rigging or overhead crane related in our learning center at mazzellacompanies.com. If you have a question of your own, drop it in the comments. My name is Ben, and I'll see you in the next one.